I'll be special. I'll stand on tall because I like to have eye contact with people. Okay, so my name is Yuval Bahar. I'm working on the hardware group of Facebook, and I'm responsible for the networking gear in Facebook. And I'm going to talk today about what Najem already pre-introduced, the six-pack. This is it. It's that simple. It's a box which is the base building block, Lego block for us for future builds. It will replace for us a lot of components which are different sizes, different vendors, different interfaces, different solutions into one standardized solution, which is going to be open. And that's what I'm going to talk about in a second. So how did we start with all this thing? We looked, first of all, when we started looking at the problem, we looked at our evolution of our data center. We started with the four posts that Najem was showing before, and we saw that we're moving to this environment, which is the fabric, super complicated environment, a lot of building blocks. One of the values that was created in this environment is that we don't depend on radix anymore. We depend on a single building block replicated hundreds of times and thousands of times in some cases to build the network that we build. So we said, okay, what do we need to build this? So we started to say, okay, first of all, let's control our top of rack. So controlling the top of rack is we're starting with the wedge. We started with the wedge. And the wedge, a lot of people asked initially, this is a weird switch, right? How come you're using only 16 ports and not the whole 32 that the chip can do? And why does it look so weird? I think now we have an answer. We want to take 12 of those and stack them together. Once we stack them together, we make out of them a six-pack. So if you look at the six-pack itself, you can see the 16 ports of the wedge twice in every slot. And so we were able to create 8 of those slots together and add 2 fabrics in the middle, which were created for us a 128x40GE building block, which is our initial Lego building block for our fabric, which will scale, like Najem said, to the higher levels as well. So let's talk a little bit about highlights of what's in six-pack. It's simple, and I'll explain what simple means. It's simple because it's actually taking a top of rack, which a lot of people can say, hey, I can build a white box top of rack. You can probably buy 50 types of white boxes out there. And we take it and use that building block to build out of that a very large non-blocking environment for us. So it's simple from a perspective that it's not complicated chassis design. I have in my history a lot of complicated chassis design. This is simple. It's scalable because it's taking one building block and can build out of it any configuration you want. We picked the six-pack because the 128x40 is our sweet spot. You can build out of that anything you want because it's completely scalable from perspective. Take more of those, put them together, build for them a new sheet metal, you got a bigger box. It's reliable from the same reason. It's the same thing replicated. We don't have complicated aspects of the chassis inside. It's all the same. It's all Ethernet. It's all working with no specialties. And the most important thing for us, it's open. We're going to open this to everybody. The sheet metal solution, the line card solution, the fabric solution, the interconnect architecture, everything is going to be open. So anybody in the ecosystem of our community over here that wants to build new systems for this, wants to build new line cards for this, want to write new software packages to this, it's open. You can take it and you can build it. You can buy it from multiple sources and we'll contribute it to OCP. If you're a silicon vendor and you want to put your silicon into the test in this environment, just build the line card. Build the line card, we'll test it, we guarantee it to you. Okay? Okay, so why did we start building it to start with? Okay, why is Facebook building hardware at all, right? That's a bit of a weird question, right? It's a software company, why are we building hardware? So the first reason that we're going for to build hardware is agility. We can build really, really quick because we extremely focus on our needs. We understand the customer really, really well because it's our data center. And we build it in a way which applies to a lot of other data centers as well. And when it applies to other data centers, we look at the big picture of how many ports are being utilized in the network today. They are probably used by about 6 or 8 vendors, which I think the Google presentation was talking about, which are consuming that. So if we are if this is applicable for us, it's applicable usually for the large operators as well. It will give us the way to run fast. If we run fast, we can build fast. The box that we're doing, the wedge was from start to power on in 3 months. The six-pack was from start to power on in 4.5 months. This is unprecedented if you are familiar with any OEM development cycles. Okay? We'll try to do innovation around hardware and software. And I'll talk a little bit more details about this. We did things that usually are non-traditional, completely out of the box. So usually when you go to a traditional switch, you're not going to be able to build it because most people are not used to it. They don't want to do it. They want an enclosed environment. This one said, let's innovate on every aspect of the solution, just like we did when we built our initial data centers. On the software side, we said, okay, we build from scratch, from the bottom up. The whole operating system is ours. We wrote all the BGPs. We wrote everything from scratch. We run everything on Linux. Everything is open. Now we can start writing features for it, and not just us. Anybody can write features to it. And the last thing is we want to do a lot of adaptation to our scale that we need. Our scale is actually bigger than what usually you see in an enterprise environment, and to do that, you'll have to optimize some of the work you do, and you need to create the flexibility to do that. So what is SixPack? Just in five bullets. It's the first open, and we emphasize open, hardware modular switching platform in the industry. It's an open platform that anybody can take. It's not a white box, it's actually blue. It's 128 by 40 gigi, non-blocking. It's non-blocking from a perspective that each line card, like Najam was describing, is facing 640 to the front right now, 640 to the back, and we'll show in a minute how that 640/640 is actually working. It's non-blocking from a perspective, it's a clause inside, similar to a four-post configuration. It runs FBOSS over Linux. FBOSS is our operating system, but it's running over a native open source Linux. If you want to write to this, FBOSS is just running as an app on top. You run your own app on top, and we have multiple people interested in writing apps already for it. It has a smart control plane, and what do you mean by smart control plane? In a lot of SDN discussions, you'll see a lot of people say, hey, the switch needs to be dumb. We'll control it from the outside. Everything is going to be okay. Just listen to us, do what we say, and configure the switch. In Facebook, we don't think like that. Because of our skill, because of the way that we can actually run this, our switches are smart. So they're running their own control plane. But we also have, on top of that, a controller which controls all of them and talks to each other. So we call it more of a hybrid SDN, where we have a centralized controller which is managing all of our network elements in the data center, but each network element is independent. It's running its own control plane, it's running its own tables, own configs, everything is done there. Okay? And the last thing, the system is 100 gig ready. We're just waiting for the silicon to stabilize. It will be 100 gig at that point, 128 by 100. Okay? So why is it special? What's so special about this? So first, it's blue, right? Second, it's open. What do we mean by open? We mean by open the top level of open. We're going to do full contribution of everything over here, from design files, board files, schematic files, specs, software specs, everything for this into the community. And we expect the community to basically embrace it and take it. We're going to run open software on it. We're going to open what we can on the software side, which is non-proprietary to us. But we'll give you a tool set big enough to be able to develop on top of this. And everything is going to create an ecosystem that can be OCP-based or any other venue that would like to use that. Disaggregation. So disaggregation is something very special for that we're driving for a long time. We're driving it across the data center, not just in the switching side. We're actually trying to disaggregate the functions, the compute functions from the storage functions, from the memory functions. In this event, what we do is we do disaggregation of the networking. We started with Wedge when we disaggregated the software from the hardware. We said the hardware data path is actually an independent unit. We run software next to it, which is controlling it, but it's completely isolated from each other. We can write a different software package and go to a partner outside that will write software package for us, but the hardware will stay the same. So that's the first step. It happened in Wedge, and it's flowing into the SixPack. System level disaggregation is what we did in SixPack. That means that we don't have centralized unit in the SixPack. I don't know if you noticed in the picture, there are only ports over there. There's no supervisor card. No raw processor, nothing is centralized. Each one of the elements are completely disaggregated to be standalone. You can run them standalone, or you can run them as a group. But they are completely independent from all aspects, the hardware and the software, all the way to the level that each card is controlling its own fans. So there's no centralized control of the cooling system. Each card is controlling and managing its fans separately. Okay? And then it gives us an opportunity as a result of that to be completely ASIC agnostic. If you can do that, our perspective on that is, if you can speak Ethernet, and everybody can speak Ethernet, you can play. So there's no specialty interconnect on the back. There's no special buses. There's no special optimization. We put everything as around Ethernet, inside and out. If you can speak Ethernet, give us a line card. It's going to be playing in the game. The last one is looks like a server. I think Najam was referring to it a little bit. We deployed on the board a server. So in reality, this switch has a microserver on it, which is pretty hefty in microserver. From a CPU perspective, it can actually can handle quite a bit. It has quite a bit of memory. It has quite a bit of storage that we can use for our purposes to develop on that different features, different aspects of our software. It has a BMC system, which by taking this act and making it look like a server, we basically converted all of our lab, all of our network, all of our CPU engineers on the data center to be network engineers. Because now they can look at this like an element of a server. This is a server, right? It's provisioned like a server. The software update is happening like a server. That's how we can push software every day. Right, when we're developing, we push software every day into our switches. There's with no precedence in any other configuration, you can push software update every day. We're now in with the large environments, we push software every 6 months on a good day, not every day. Okay, it gives us also the opportunity to do very fast software development. If we need a new feature, we go to the desk next to ours and say, hey, we need this feature. And after a day or two, you get it. When compared to a large enterprise which needs to adhere to a lot of customers, you ask for a feature, sometimes it takes not 2 days, maybe 2 months, maybe 2 years in some cases, if you get it all. This is an eye chart, so I won't read through it. I'm just going to look at the highlights, right? The hardware architecture is open and Ethernet only. That's a very strong key that we are going to maintain really, really religiously, okay? It's a dual stage spine leaf. We are actually switching twice in the box. So a lot of switches that you will see have a single switching stage at the beginning. The back side of it is just a crossbar. This one is actually doing dual stage switching. So it gives us a lot of advantage when we actually manage the network, because we're actually managing this not as a box, but as 12 independent switches, and we can manage each and every one of them separately. We obviously optimize the interface inside the box to be much more efficient, but it's still Ethernet, and anybody can optimize it in whatever way they feel to actually optimize it in the box. Our feature velocity, like I said, is extremely fast because it's Linux. You just write an app on top of Linux, you just got yourself a new feature, okay? I'm simplifying a little bit the work that the software people are doing, but in general, this is how it is, okay? All of our building blocks are off the shelf. There's nothing proprietary over here, nothing. So if you can handle off-the-shelf components from the different ASIC vendors, from the different power vendors, cooling vendors, you can actually be a part of this. And our growth cycle for this is 8 to 12 months. So we're going to spin this every 8 to 12 months. And we're going to move it to the next level, which was a very, very big blocking aspect for us on the four-post configurations, where we couldn't get the large switches in the center to grow fast enough in capacity or in bandwidth. Now this is opening the door for us to do whatever we need in that environment. So let's take a closer look. Let's look at the system first. You can see on the system, two line cards on the top, two line card slots, two line card slots on the bottom, two fabrics in the middle. That's, by the way, the source of the six pack. It actually has six slots in there if you ignore the power shelf, which is important but not really critical for our networking side. And it's definitely not referring to my six pack, so. So that's where the six pack came from. We have a configuration in the back which is unique. We have two backplanes in this box. And the reason that we created two backplanes is we created two backplanes to minimize the length of the backplane. We don't do any crossing on the backplane. The backplanes are all point to point, and all the sophisticated crossing is happening through the fabric cards. Okay? We have front access only, so we don't have cards on the back. The only reason to go to the back is actually to plug in and out. As you can see over here, in this case, we have also front access to this. All the cooling system is 1+1. If you can see those little fans over here, each one of them is an independent fan unit, which actually associates itself with the front card. Even the fabric has two separate fan units, where the left side and the right side manage themselves by separately, completely autonomously. So they don't care if the left side is hot, because they're going to cool the right side, because they're managing just the right side. Even on the fabric itself, and I'll talk about the fabric in a second, we have two microservers, which are separating the left and the right side, okay? We have dual out-of-band network, which is actually also shared into the internal IPC network that we're dealing with. It's a 3,000-watt system, 7RU, 19-inch rack. So it can be adopted into any environment, including an open rack environment where we have adapters to physically match it. This is just a high-level data path block diagram. It's basically showing that we're doing a full cloth, full mesh, point-to-point. Every line card goes to the switches in the fabric. The fabric has two switches on it, and I'll show a picture in a minute. Everything in the box is 40 gig. It's 100 gig ready. When we have 100 gig available for us from our switching technology, it will go to 100 gig. Okay? Let's look at the line card for a second. So first of all, it's a full leverage from wedge. So if you look at the wedge picture on the bottom that we announced about 6 months ago, and you just take the element which is in the circle over there, move it up, this is what's in the line card. This is exactly what's in the line card, actually. We didn't even spin it. It's the same board. It's the same mechanism. The one on the bottom looks red, and the one on the top looks yellow on the line card, but that's only because it's different stages of our development. Okay, it's identical leverage from wedge. It's a half slot, 16 by 40 to the front and 640 to the back. The 640 to the back right now is running as 16 by 40 as well, but you can run other configurations if you want. So the topology on the back is completely in your control. It's a single 1.28 terabit switching element, which everybody knows who it is, so I won't mention it. It's an OCP microserver and it runs FBOS. We have an onboard BMC, like we said, to be able to make this look like a server. It has an OCP debug port. This is 130 watts, 1RU. Okay, the fabric, as you can see, it's interesting. It has a replication of two line cards in reality. You can see the left side and the right side. You can see two microservers. The reason they are shifted like that in the microservers in the front is for cooling reasons. You see the backplane connectors are split. And you see the two white connectors over there are the two independent cooling system for the left and the right side. So you basically run them separately. Okay, it's a dual line card configuration, 2x128. So you can see that we have 8 on the line cards plus 2x4 on the fabrics, basically makes it non-blocking, as much as non-blocking as possible in this environment. Again, runs FBOS, dual BMC, everything is replicated, and a full logical split between the left and the right. This card is doing just a single element of centralization, and that's pulling out all of our out-of-band Gigi interface to the front to enable us to run off 2 Gigi external out-of-band ports instead of running 12 of them. Okay? If you look at the software, we talked about this. I'll just browse through this quickly. Running FBOS on this. FBOS is an application running on top of Linux, and we're running BMC. The BMC is basically doing all the low-level stuff, which actually makes it look like a server. So the BMC combined with the microserver is actually what makes it look like a server, manage like a server, run like a server, okay? The Gigi IPC is actually connecting all of our servers together, but there is no centralized function that requires the IPC inside the box. The IPC inside the box is just for hello, I'm there, I'm here, sharing information, IP addresses, etc. It's a completely distributed control plane from our perspective. Each and every one of the elements in six-pack runs its own control plane. It's distributed, not centralized. So you never get to a point that things are centralized. You never get to a point that your raw processor costs you $500,000 because it's actually just a local server sitting on your switch. Okay? And this is six-pack. This is an open version of that, and we will have it over here during the lunch break if you guys want to play with it. Not mess with it too much, but you can touch it if you want. Okay, so what's next? So we'll do a full contribution to OCP. So this will be an open system going to OCP. We'll open source the software as much as we can, like I said, and the different aspect of the software. It will build an ecosystem that we already started to build with our OCP partners to be able to bring this thing to the level that this is an open platform common to the industry that anybody can develop in, and everybody will benefit from it. Because if we have a partner X, which is building a line card, which is doing a function of routing, for example, then we don't need to do it. And we can take it from them. Or if we build the first line card, which is doing 100 gig, they can share it from us and get it from us. Okay? So that ecosystem is very important. And on top of that will be ecosystem of software people, which will run different packages, different operating systems, different feature sets, and give support models to the customers that want to take it but don't want to pay the hefty price of getting a support model from other places. Okay? We'll build higher radics. Higher radics, basically, this one is a sweet spot for us. It's a 128 by 40 and fits very well as a Lego block into the environment that Alexis is going to talk about in a minute. But we are considering doing larger, 12-pack, 24-pack, any other configuration that we can see a need for it in our data center. We're building next-generation line cards, which are different functions that can enter into a networking environment, if it's routing, if it's OTN, if it's all kind of things that you can think of. Obviously, those line cards will fit in. Since this is Ethernet only to the back, all of those line cards, as long as it can talk Ethernet to the back, they're all set, they're part of the box, okay? They have their own control plane, so if they need to run their own control plane, they need to run a different operating system function, there's no limitation. So you can mix and match operating systems on the box from line cards that come from different places with no issue, as long as the management system can handle it. We will scale this to 100, like I said, as soon as we have the quality that we need from the ASIC development of 100 gig. It will come from different vendors. I think in 100 gig it will be the year of everybody is getting into the game. And we do much more. So we have a very extensive plan of doing things which are, as much as this is disruptive, we'll do things which are much more disruptive in the industry to enable people to do better things faster. Our goal as Facebook is to share our knowledge with the world to enable people to build better data centers, more efficient, more scalable, more reliable for us and for them. This is the goal that we have. Just as an altruistic goal. We don't get money off that. We don't sell six-pack, by the way. You can't order six-pack tomorrow. So, okay. Oops, did I go backwards? Yeah. Okay, with that, I'll close. So just in summary, we started from Wedge. We built six-pack. We put on top of it FBOS and BMC. We built an ecosystem, and we're going to contribute this to OCP, and that will take us to the next level of switching in the whole industry. With that, thank you very much, and we're just trying to put all the people that contributed to the project.